Hey everyone, I'm Hannah and this is my updated hair routine. I have not shared my hair routine in a few years and my hair is a little longer now. It's not a pixie anymore. And I often do my hair with a flat iron, which I know is very popular because we all have different techniques for using one. And this video is made possible by some free products that were sent to me from Amika. I'm already a fan of them, but if they want to send me free stuff, I am cool with that. So thanks for the free stuff, Amika. So the first thing you're gonna see is that my hair is soaking wet, freshly washed. I had used Amika 3D Volume and Thickening Shampoo and Conditioner because it makes my hair feel really thick and textured, which is really helpful for doing this hairstyle. I often use shampoos that are either for volume or thickening just because I feel like my own hair texture thickness is kind of on the thin side. Plus, Amika products smell really delicious and they have a lot of good ingredients in them that are healthy for your hair. Then I put a huge dollop of mousse in my hair, not Amika brand. I work it through. Then about 99% of the time I let my hair air dry, and my natural hair is about a 2C, which is like a little bit of a curl, a little bit of a wave. Because of its unique mix, I am able to brush it out to look straight. But if you'll keep watching, it won't actually dry that straight, but it dries straight enough that it gives me a good base for this hairstyle. So because of my chronic fatigue syndrome, I'm not able to really wash my hair in the daytime because I take too many naps. So I actually wash my hair usually about 3 hours before bed. Luckily, in like that time frame, my hair usually gets about 90% dry, and so I don't mind falling asleep if it's just a smidge wet. I have tricks to fix it when I wake up in the morning. So speaking of that, I am gonna let it air dry for a few hours and then I'm gonna go to sleep and you will see what happens in the morning. I woke up like this. No, I did not. I just finished doing my makeup because I'm getting ready for work. If you wanna see my makeup routine, let me know down below because it is a little different than the last time I shared it, which was like 3 years ago. But right now we're focusing on hair. So my hair is dry and as you can see, it has a lot of, let's call it texture. Some of it is from air drying and some of it is just scrunched from a pillow, but it's gonna look completely different in a minute. So first, we're gonna need a lot of clips. I get a little clip happy. I just clip, 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 clip. Even though I have like regular textured hair, I just clip and get as many layers as I can. Might be overkill, but you know, the results are good, so it must be working for me. So next, when my straightener is all heated up, I'm going to flat iron the roots. You could do this as you go, but I find that it's easier to do it before I do all the other steps. You'll understand as we keep going. So here is after I flat iron just the roots, and it already looks really different, doesn't it? So next, I'm gonna clip it again. I clip it a little differently the second time. So I clip up both the sides and then half of the back. And it's because I put a lot of importance on getting the back of my hair now that I work in the public and people actually do see the back of my hair. I can't get away with doing just the front like I used to for any like blog post. Okay, so now here comes my technique because everybody has some trick about how to use their hair straightener. First of all, you will not get it right the first time or for like the first few months. It takes a lot of practice, but this is what works for me. Now, if you can get to the back of your hair, which is only recently that I could do that because you guys know I've been growing out a pixie for the last few years. And also I just said I start in the back because I want to make sure the back of my hair turns out really good. So I pull from the top and about halfway down is when I turn the iron and pull. This would be a good time to let you know that the back of my hair does not hold a curl. It does not hold my natural curl and it doesn't hold an artificial curl. And it kind of drives me crazy because I'd like to be able to wear my hair naturally curly, but half of it is not naturally curly. So it looks like I have two different textures going on. It's a weird look. But if you remember, I bragged about loving my curly hair when it was a pixie, and that's because you couldn't see the back when it was straight because it just all looked curly because it was short. So if you've ever wondered why I suddenly am not wearing my hair naturally curly, that's why. I'm hoping when it gets a little longer that maybe it'll change. And like all the greats, I alternate sides and patterns and stuff. Like how this looks is actually pretty good for the back of my hair. So basically I just do that layer by layer. So I actually did it pretty good on the first try. This is kind of rare, even though I was saying how it's gonna take you forever to master. One very important thing I forgot to mention is that you wanna do the curls way tighter than you'd expect, because especially for me, a big trick to this hairstyle is letting it like relax throughout the day and it gets a little more bohemian looking. But now it's time for the most important step. So as you may have noticed, I did not put any products in my hair. You know, we did the mousse after the shower, but otherwise nothing. I have experimented with a lot of different things in the past, but I actually find out that products just weigh my hair down and I don't need that kind of negativity in my life. But you see these bangs? They're gonna keep falling in my face, and I'm getting ready to go to work, and I can't have bangs in my face when I'm like trying to help customers. So, a little trick that I found is I either use a dry shampoo or texture spray. Today I'm going to use a dry shampoo, and I'm just gonna blast that all in the front here, and it gives the front just a little bit of grit, and it holds like magic all day. Plus, it smells delicious. So it's kind of like an alternative to hairspray, but it'll give your hair more of a natural grit and hold rather than hairspray, which like cements your hair. I mean, depending on what brand you use, but for me, dry shampoo and texture spray all the way. So it's just about done. As I said, I like to let the hairstyle just kind of relax. I do break it up a little bit with my fingers. I mean, it's already kind of loose curls, so it doesn't need much. I just don't want them to like start clumping together or anything. But this is the final product. This is beautiful, right? I hope that you guys enjoyed my hair routine as much as I had fun sharing it with you. Again, thank you to Amika for sending me some free products to use in this video. If you enjoyed the content that I create online, whether it's my videos, my blog posts, my Instagrams, then be sure to support it by giving it a thumbs up, sharing it with your friends, commenting on it, following, liking, all that good stuff. Hopefully, I will see you around on the internet, and in the meantime, be excellent to each other.